Welcome to this new tutorial series about Blender. In this tutorial, we're going to show you a little bit of background about Blender and we'll also set up your computer so you're good to go for all the next tutorials. So here we are at the website of Blender, blender.org. And Blender is not only a 3D model program, you can do a lot more, and that's something I'll discuss with you later. Blender is developed in the Netherlands. It has its headquarters in Amsterdam. And the founder of Blender is Ton Roosendaal. Back in the days, he founded the company Not a Number, and they were developing Blender. And what happened was that there were quite some people using Blender, although the whole controls were a little bit cumbersome. But one day the whole company went bankrupt and there was still a community who wanted to continue with Blender but couldn't because the company went bankrupt. So what happens is that there was a proposal from the banks. If they had 100,000 euro, then they could buy the source. So in 7 weeks the community collected this 100,000 euros, and Ton Roosendaal was able to found the Blender Foundation. And this Blender Foundation managed the source code and is still developing on Blender, and there are a lot of projects going on inside the Blender Foundation. So everyone could now access Blender and use it for whatever they want. So what can you do with Blender? Well, on their website, they have this header features, and they listed all the features of this tool. So you can render stuff, but you can also model stuff. And one of the nice things is even sculpting, which is something like digital clay. You can also use it for animation and rigging, which makes your 3D character have natural animations with like a skeleton. We also have 2D graphics. So it's not only a 3D tool. If you look at a grease pencil, it's a 2D animation. Can also use Blender for video effects like motion capturing and that kind of thing. So you can actually track your camera if you make a recording and place 3D objects in your recording. And it's actually looking like it's there because Blender can track your camera movement and translate it into an artificial camera in Blender. So that's also pretty cool. So if we scroll down a little bit, you'll see even more. You see that you can also do simulations. You have video editing. Yes, there is a video editor inside Blender. You can also write scripts in Python, and you can also use this for add-ons. There are a lot of add-ons for Blender which are written in Python, and you can use it to extend the functionality of Blender. To give you an idea about the capabilities of Blender, I opened a part of this Blender reel which is made for SIGGRAPH 2019. SIGGRAPH is a computer graphics exhibition, and every year there's this short video showing all kind of cool videos made with Blender. I put these in the description of this video, the links, so you can see them for yourself. This is just a short pick from all these videos. And we will continue with another part, which is called Open Movies. In 2006, there was something unique going on. Blender featured the first open movie called Elephant's Dream. And Elephant's Dream is a movie where all the assets are kind of open source. That's why it's called an open movie. And it's quite unique at the time, but because this never happened before. After Elephant's Dream, there were also other movies, as you can see over here. And I recommend you to see them all, because then you can see how powerful Blender is. The last one is here in 2019, it's called Spring, and these videos give you an idea about the 2D and 3D capabilities of Blender. Here at the bottom you also see Open Games, and that's because in 2008 Blender had a game engine, so you could even make games. However, since Blender, if I remember correctly, 2.7, the game engine is removed, so you're not able to create these games anymore. But back in the time, it was a game engine, so that's why this Yo Frankie game is still listed on their website. For Blender, you only need a computer. This could be a Windows machine, a Mac, or even Linux. Beside a computer, you might want to have a fast graphics card. It's not needed, but it can speed up things a lot. So if you have a lot of complex animation which need a lot of calculations, then you might want to look into a fast computer graphics card. But it's not needed. I don't have a fancy video card. I just use my MacBook Pro and it will work. So that's very nice. Another thing you might want to have is a 3-button mouse. In Windows this is default, but not on Mac. And I like it because with the navigation it's really nice if you have a third mouse button. On the Blender website you'll find this button which says download Blender. The current version is 2.82, but you might have a different one. And then you can choose which one you want. Do you want the Windows, the Linux, or the Mac version? Once you're done downloading, on Windows you run the setup, on the Mac you just drag Blender to the application folder, and then you're good to go. You're ready to start Blender. So if you install Blender now and open it, we then continue from there. When you start Blender for the first time, you see this quick setup. Here you can set the shortcuts, the way you want to select things, etc. You might think, why do I want to select with my right mouse button? That's because in the older versions of Blender, you had to use the right mouse button to select stuff. I keep everything default since I'm recording tutorials, and it's quite hard if everyone needs to change their settings according to mine. So I press the next button. Then this screen shows up. It's the Blender splash screen where you can say what kind of new file you want. You can also read the manual, go to the Blender website. You can open existing projects, but I'm going to choose for general. And here we are. This is Blender. Here you see a camera. You also see a lamp. You also see the cube. In another video, I'm going to explain everything to you. For now, we're going to preferences in the edit menu. Because there's one thing I really like to change, and that's on the system, and it's the number of undo steps. It's set to 32, and I like to increase it a lot, so I make it 256. It will save a lot of time because you can do more undos. It takes a little bit more of memory, so maybe your computer can keep up with the 256. But then you just make it 128 and you figure it out yourself. But I like to have a lot of undo steps. So now we're ready for the first real Blender tutorial. If you have any questions, you can drop them in the comments, and there also you find all the links I've mentioned in this video. I see you in the next episode.